Are you dying to know what Betty will be shooting this coming season? Who's next to wet their pants?
Oh, Jesus.
And if any more feet will get mowed at the new Sterling Cooper Draper Pryce? Next season will pick up in 1964 when women's lib, rock and roll, and civil rights were giving men like Roger Sterling coronaries. I expect in this season we'll see a lot about how America was becoming a hipper, looser place.
Feel a go-around like you've never had.
But I don't expect to see much from President Obama's favorite TV show about the massive expansion of government and the rise of the nanny state.
Why couldn't you tell me any of this?
Here's what season four will probably get wrong and right about the mid-60s. In 1964, women were breaking free from the dull churn of domestic life. In season four, Betty will have discovered better ways to meet her needs. This season, she'll complete her transformation into a divorcee with a spine.
You lied to me every day.
Watch for Peggy, sporting a new perm, to continue her climb up the career ladder.
Congratulations, more work and more responsibility.
I'm also hoping the supremely talented Joan will move from office manager to vice president. That'll happen around the same time as she drops Greg, her pathetic date-raping husband.
Do you think I'm a bigot? I just want to know why you bought your TV.
Black Americans were increasing their purchasing power in the mid-60s. This should lead Pete to steer more clients towards this lucrative market.
It seems illogical to me that they would reject an opportunity to make more money.
Racist executives who ignore Pete's advice will see their businesses fail.
The sun shines bright on the old Kentucky home.
I'm also betting Roger Sterling will reluctantly hire his first black underling who doesn't push a broom or operate an elevator.
Well, early in the morning.
Forget guitar-strumming priests. Come on and twist it and go. I bet Don's daughter Sally becomes a Beatle maniac, and Jane Sterling falls for Mick Jagger.
Overboard and drown.
And the office girls will be dropping their girdles as fashion and style become less restrained.
Where do they go?
I dread the inevitable episode in which the 1964 Surgeon General report breaks the news that smoking causes cancer. Expect to see those evil Lucky Strike execs back in Don's office looking to dupe Americans into lighting up. There's little evidence that advertising was ever crucial in getting people to start smoking. Rather, it's used to get them to smoke particular brands.
I'm Henry Francis, Governor Rockefeller's Director of Public Relations and Research.
We'll probably be hearing a lot more about Governor Nelson Rockefeller now that Henry Francis and Betty are an item. Henry's one of Rocky's top men.
And classic strategist, fundraiser, maybe campaign manager.
But I don't expect you'll come away with a sense of how awful Rockefeller really was. His free-spending ways put New York on the road to fiscal disaster. And he created the Rockefeller drug laws, which put generations of minor offenders in jail for upwards of 15 years. LBJ will be taken to task for moving America more gingerly into Vietnam. But his other war won't be criticized.
And this administration today, here and now, declares unconditional war on poverty in America.
Yet the war on poverty was as unsuccessful in achieving its objectives as his war in Vietnam. All it did was make it that much harder to escape poverty.
Have you read her? Rand. Atlas Shrugged. That's the one.
Unfortunately, the amoral Bert Cooper is Mad Men's token libertarian. I'm predicting Bert will be a supporter of 1964 presidential candidate Barry Goldwater.
Extremism in the defense of liberty is no vice.
But I don't expect any honest conversations about Lyndon Johnson's infamous Daisy Act. That spot depicted Barry Goldwater as a mad bomber, even as LBJ was getting to drop more bombs on Vietnam than were dropped in World War II. Yeah. For Reason TV, I'm Nick Gillespie.